Okay, so the next one is the moral law. Christians in debates are famous for saying, atheists have no foundation for morality. They're stealing from the Christian worldview. You know, obviously, I think that's hogwash. Mm-hmm. I can just tell you, let me just, can I give just a brief view of how I see morality?
Sure.
Okay, so basically I think morality is all about behavior, what is good and bad. And so then people say, what does good and bad mean? So good are things that help a community flourish, and bad are things that hurt the community. And so how do we determine what's good and bad? Well, I think there are three principles that have been proven over time that are really good at determining that. Because every moral question is a little bit different, and so sometimes some of these principles work more than others, or they lean on them more heavily than the others. And these three principles from my own study are consequentialism, reciprocity, and individual rights. Consequentialism means you view what are the outcomes of this action if I do it. If it's going to be harmful, then it's bad morals, and if it's positive, it's going to be good. Mm-hmm. Reciprocity is treating other people like you'd want them to treat you, like Jesus said and Confucius hundreds of years before him. And then individual rights are basically the idea that, hey, as long as it doesn't hurt anybody else or hurt yourself even, go ahead, do whatever you want to, you know? I mean, you know, so this is kind of the idea where somebody says that behavior is icky, and it's like, well, it doesn't affect you. Well, I want to do it, so, okay, I guess we shouldn't make a law against it because it's none of my business. So basically, that's my view in a nutshell.
Okay. Well, I would say, yeah, you can know the moral law and still be an atheist. I think everybody really knows it, but I think is grounding it that it's real, you're gonna have to presuppose a moral lawgiver.
I didn't presuppose that at all. You heard what I said.
Yeah, I know, but here's why. Do you believe that humans are supposed to behave a certain way?
They are if they want to get along nice. That's the condition for it.
Well, that would be a condition, but if you say there really is a way that human behavior ought to be, that's not invented.
No, I don't think there is a way they ought to be. If they want to avoid prison, they better operate a certain way. If they want to have friends, they better operate a certain way. If they want to have a good community, they better operate a certain way. But I don't think there's anything from above that says a human must operate a certain way.
Okay, would you say that if something is true, then everyone ought to believe it?
If something is true, now you got to be careful about what you mean by true, because true in morality is different than true in science.
Yeah, I'm talking about oughtness. Like, do you believe everyone ought to believe your true position?
I believe, let me put it this way. Like I said, I have three principles on how to judge the morality of something.
That would be how to discover it, right?
Okay, but hold on a second. I believe there's three principles, and so if I want to be a good person, that's what I ought to do. If I don't want to be a good person, I don't have to do it, but I ought to do it if I want to be a good person. Hitler, for example, Hitler had his own morality. If Hitler wants to be a good Nazi, then he ought to do what his morality told him to do. You ought to do what you believe is right.
Would you say that everybody should believe your true position?
I think my position is superior. My principles are superior.
But if you say everybody should, huh? Then you're admitting that if you say everybody should believe your position, then you are presupposing objective moral values.
The only reason why I think they should, I think people should follow my morality understanding, because as far as I'm concerned, it's the best. And if somebody wants to argue with me, I will present why. And if they have a better system, I will change my mind. But the only reason why I think people ought to follow my moral system is because I believe it's the best.
So you're presupposing that perfection is real, that it really is something that we're supposed to be striving for, that benefits are real, flourishing is what we're supposed to be going after, mm-hmm. that we ought to flourish, that consequences ought to be avoided. All of that is presupposing a plan for human behavior.
Nope.
If you say that humans are, if you say there's no plan, then there's no ought.
No, I believe that
there's
humans...
not really an ought.
No, I believe, what's so difficult to say that I believe that we all want to live in peace and harmony and we want to flourish? That has nothing to do with some kind of God's plan. Every animal, every monkey, ape, whale, everything wants to flourish.
Flourishing would be a goal. That you would say that the human form is such that if it receives certain things, then it will have the end goal of doing what we call flourishing, receiving benefits or goods or whatever, that's all goal-oriented. So what you have said is that there's a way that humans are supposed to behave in order to fulfill what our end goal is. That mm-hmm. you're presupposing that there's perfection, that's real, that goodness is real. All of that is actually presupposing that there's a way things are supposed to be. If there's objective moral values, it's got to come from a mind. Like, would you say that what is good is objective, that all minds can know it?
What is good is objective? No, yeah, I don't believe, I don't follow that kind of thought process. Yeah,
objective just means all minds can know it, that we can all know what goodness is.
Well, I have a different goodness than Nazi morality. They have a different goodness. You would have a different goodness. For example, if you're
judging them to an outside
you know what?
Standard.
Well, like, for example, if you're a Jew living under the Old Testament, in Deuteronomy 22, it says to kill a woman on her wedding night if she's suspected of being a non-virgin. They would say that is good. That is right. And I would say that's sickening and gross. So that's good according to their moral system. That's good according to their holy book, but it's not good according to me.
Okay. But who are you? I mean, what basis do you have for saying they ought not do that? You're appealing mm-hmm. to a universal moral law
I'm not appealing to the universal law. I'm appealing to the goal. Like you said, there's a goal of flourishing. That's what morality is all about, is a goal. Just like math is about numbers, morality is about flourishing.
Yeah, but that's how atheists do this double speak all the time. Where they'll say morality is not objective, it's not for everybody, and this is what everybody ought to believe. You all ought to believe in this goodness, and then suddenly start appealing to this universal objective moral standard that you just said is not really real.
Well, I would explain why my moral system is superior to your Bible-based moral system and superior to Nazi morality and Mormon morality, Hindu morality. Let's put all the moralities on the table and see which one's best. I would argue that mine is best. And if you ask me why, I would say because it's best for community flourishing. And you would say yours is best because it pleases God more. You know, it's like totally different goals.
I would use natural law. I would say that natural law should be what the like the United States government should be based on, not biblical divine law. You know, I would take the Jeffersonian position on that. But like you would say, all minds can know that the Earth is a sphere, right?
Okay, but see, now you're getting into scientific facts. Yes, of course.
Yeah, you would say that's an objective truth. You would like if I said I invented mm-hmm. that the Earth is a sphere, mm-hmm. you'd be like, no, you didn't, because everybody can discover
right,
that.
Right, right, right.
So, same thing with what really is good. Can everybody really know that stabbing somebody to death for fun? Can everybody know that?
I just gave you a clear example where, in the Old Testament, killing a suspected virgin. If you were living back then under God's rule, you would say that was good, and I would say that is sick and gross. So we cannot agree what is good, especially when you use that. You say this is good because God said it. Divine command theory.
No. I'm using natural law theory that if goodness is real, you're presupposing that there's a way that we ought to be behaving. Only minds can set goals for human behavior. If you say that we get to invent what's morality, then it's not really real. It would be Bernie saying, Brian, I don't think, like you're basically
how could you say goodness?
Hey, you shouldn't do what I don't think you should do.
How could you say goodness is real when me and you have totally different ideas of what's good?
Well, I mean, we don't have different ideas about
sure,
what's good.
Sure. Do you think it's good to turn the other cheek to Osama bin Laden?
When Jesus said that, he was not talking about the government. That's a person-to-person relationship, not person-to-authority relationship. The government should not turn the other cheek. But
where do you get that from the Bible? Where does it say the government should not turn the other cheek?
In Romans chapter 12, it actually goes through person-to-person relationships, that as long as it has to do with you, you should live at peace. Then Romans 13 goes right into the government does not bear the sword in vain, and it actually splits the two, that there's a way that the government behaves, that the authority behaves right. towards the citizen versus how citizens relate to other citizens.
Right, right. The government does not wield its sword in vain, but still, when should the government use a sword? If you had a Christian, what if you had a Christian pacifist president that said, you know what we really need to do is just love and pray for Osama. Let's invite him to the White House, give him a big royal banquet, and let's see if we can change his mind.
Then I would say that he is not applying that biblical teaching in the correct way. That I forgive those who harm me, but if I am the President of the United States, we wouldn't say it's my duty to forgive Osama bin Laden, then I use justice to go after him, because it would be a category mistake to apply the principle to citizen-to-citizen relationships to citizen-to-government.
Okay, well, we need to move on to the next subject.
These minutes go by fast.
Yeah, and we only got 6 minutes for each one now because we went over time. So. Oh.